Hello, I'm Rich Statuto, the President and CEO of Bon Secours Health System. I'm pleased to have the opportunity to make some brief comments to this group this morning. I don't know how familiar you are with Bon Secours Health System. We're located on the East Coast. We have six states and many communities that we serve. And we have a mission to bring people and communities to health and wholeness. It's part of our Catholic health ministry, and we invest a lot in the needs of those who are poor and vulnerable in addition to running our health system. I'll have to tell you that there's been so many cuts in reimbursement to providers over the last 5 years that it's put a lot of strain on our organization and organizations across the United States that provide health care. One of the things that we've been doing, we have a stewardship committee that I chair. We meet on a monthly basis, and we're constantly looking at opportunities to reduce our fixed costs and to standardize what we do. So in the last 5 years, we've saved $587 million that we've documented in order to generate the funds that we need to invest in our communities, to invest in response to the poor and the vulnerable, and to invest in the type of talent that we need in our organization. You know, we've come to the point after you reduce expenses by $587 million, we've come to the point where we're still experiencing cuts in our reimbursement, and it's starting to get difficult. This year, I'm sure you know about the 340B program and the fact that we have incurred another 28.5% cut in 340B as a result of the ACA. The Medicaid disproportionate share for hospital payments are cut, CHIP funding, and a number of Medicare extenders are in the pipeline to expire. The reality is that we as healthcare leaders need to continually be alert to these provider cuts. The one that's on the currently changing is the site neutral payments, and other Medicare payments could appear at any time. So we need to explore every avenue to reduce expenses so that we can provide the quality of care, we can improve health, and for Bon Secours, our mission is to create healthy communities. So our response, our best solution for Bon Secours Health System is the premier, highly committed program. We believe it provides better value for the members, for Bon Secours, and I think it provides better value for the suppliers. Top performing companies in healthcare and other industries have streamlined their supply chains, and based on preferred vendors and top categories of spend, have been able to reduce variation and enable utilization analysis and reduce costs. Premier's highly committed program will scale this practice to a new level, and we're excited. We're excited about it. What we need to change now is our culture in our organization to product standardization and vendor standardization. It won't be easy, but I can tell you as the CEO of Bon Secours Health System, we are committed to it. All of our BSHE leaders will support the HCP, the highly committed program, contract decisions, and will ensure our physicians and clinicians are engaged in the process and the responsibility for compliance that will be cascaded throughout our organization. So, Bon Secours Health System, we have some steps that we are taking to get ready for this committed program. David McCombs is a highly capable supply chain leader and is creating for us, working through our stewardship committee, creating a new model for operating and managing our expenses with our supplies and purchases. We're establishing, number one, a CEO oversight model for performance and compliance, monitoring the direct facility CEO's approval of these contracts. We're establishing compliance dashboards so we know how well we're performing with these contracts. We're developing product order management controls on the front end to limit non-compliant purchases. We're developing new clinician education orientation for all of our physicians. We're developing an executive oversight model that will meet on a quarterly basis. So the executive oversight will include the regional CEOs, will include my executive management team to make sure we're delivering on this. Thank you for listening to me. I know I went on and on, but this is really important for us. And I thank you for your time and your participation. And most of all, I thank you for helping us control our costs in this new disruptive environment that we're operating in. Our ultimate goal is the quality of care that we provide within our facilities, keeping people healthy, and responding to the vulnerabilities and the people that fall through the cracks. Thank you so much.